Hey everybody! So last week, Pocket Mortys was released on iOS and Android, and I'm here to tell you whether or not it's worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
Have you ever wondered what Pokemon would be like if it featured the cast and characters from Rick and Morty? Probably not, but developer Big Pixel Games has done just that with their latest game, Pocket Mortys. Based on the hit Adult Swim television show, Pocket Morty sees our titular characters working on an experiment in the garage when all of a sudden a Rick from an alternate dimension shows up and demands Rick's Morty. When he doesn't give him up, the two Ricks have their Mortys fight each other and after defeating him, travel through a portal to the Citadel of Ricks, where the Council of Ricks confiscate his portal gun and say that if he wants it back, he needs to prove himself as the best Morty trainer around by battling other Ricks, collecting badges, and defeating each member of the Council. Like I mentioned before, Pocket Mortys is essentially Pokemon, but with various Mortys replacing the Pokemon themselves. Outside of the main Morty, each Morty boils down into three categories: rock, paper, and scissors, with the rules of the game dictating which Mortys will have an advantage over others. You can capture wild Mortys by tiring them out and placing a manipulator chip on them, and once you fill out your party, any other Mortys you capture will then go to the daycare at the Citadel. You can heal your Mortys and restore their action points, this game's version of PP, and buy various items and buffs, but anyone familiar with Pokemon should feel right at home with Pocket Mortys. Though it's a bit on the simple side, the game provides quite a bit of challenge at times, but never enough to overwhelm those that may not be familiar with how to play these kinds of games. It's a fun pick-up-and-play title that you can sink a ton of hours into, and with a myriad side quests and over 80 Mortys to capture, there's plenty to do to keep you entertained for a long time to come, especially if you're a fan of the series. Even if you aren't, there's plenty to do and see, and it's a great time waster when you have a few hours to kill. Seeing as how this is a free-to-play game, like most free-to-play games, Pocket Mortys includes microtransactions. While I'm usually against the practice, as generally it nickels and dimes players into a pay-to-win scenario, Pocket Mortys takes a smarter approach, offering players a way to pay if they wish, but never requiring them to pay in order to fully enjoy the game. The way the system works is by way of a vending machine, which accepts tickets in exchange for a grab bag of items, buffs, and potentially new Mortys that you may have otherwise not found out in the wild. You'll unlock tickets at random after some of the more difficult boss battles, but you can shell out anywhere from $1 to $10 in order to get more tickets quickly. I put about 25 hours into Pocket Mortys, beating the game in its entirety, and not once did I ever have to shell out real-world money for a ticket. In an era where the mobile game market is rife with games that abuse the free-to-play system, it was refreshing to see a game that handled microtransactions in this way, especially as a licensed title based on a show. That being said, the game does have its fair share of issues. Probably the biggest gripe I have is how battle areas are laid out. Once you transport to a new area, you are stuck there until you either beat the boss and get the badge, or your entire party is wiped out. On its own, that's not a wholly bad thing, but it becomes annoying when you're forced to wipe out your entire party on purpose in order to get back to the hub world. The randomly generated nature of the areas can also be a bit of a double-edged sword, as you'll never have the chance to go back to a certain area once you've left. This means that you need to get everything done in one go, or hope that you end up in a similar area sooner rather than later. There's also a distinct lack of variety in the areas themselves, with a lot of the same backgrounds and assets used over and over again. You can make the same argument for the repetitive dialogue and constant usage of the same Mortys over and over again, but I was a little bit more forgiving of that due to there being enough variety to keep it from getting too stale too quickly. In the end, Pocket Mortys is a fun, albeit flawed Pokemon clone that fans of the show are sure to enjoy. It's a bit on the simple side, but is a great pick-up-and-play title that can challenge as much as it can entertain. Despite some issues with how battle areas are handled and the tendency for the game to repeat itself over and over again, the game handles microtransactions in a smart and interesting way that doesn't force the player into a pay-to-win situation that seems to be the norm with a lot of mobile games nowadays. With bright, colorful graphics, an intriguing and well-done soundtrack, and plenty to do and see, Pocket Mortys will keep you entertained for a long time to come. If you're a fan of the show or interested in giving this game a look, I highly recommend it.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Have you had a chance to play it yet? Are you a fan of Rick and Morty? Be sure to leave a comment below letting me know what you think, but as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time.